Hey everyone! Did you know that artificial intelligence can create art? Take a look at the painting on my left. Do you see anything special about it? Well, it has been created by a piece of artificial intelligence. If you're curious on how an algorithm created something like this, then keep watching. In this video, we'll see two state-of-the-art techniques that are used by artificial intelligence to be creative, and we'll see some of the most interesting artworks that have been created until now. So here's the first technology that we'll learn about today, and it's GAN, Generative Adversarial Networks. And I'd like to introduce them to you with an example. Imagine having two kids that have never seen a dog in their life to be in the same room. These kids are both extraordinarily smart, and you decide that you want to run a small experiment. You give one child, Bob, a book full of pictures of dogs, and you give the other child, Alice, a pen and several pieces of paper. And you explain to them that they're going to play a game. Alice will have to draw the shape of a dog. She has endless attempts, and keep in mind, she has never seen a dog in her life. Every time she tries, Bob, based on all the pictures of the dogs that are in the book, will either accept the drawing if it looks similar enough to any of those dogs or reject it. The process might take hours, days, or even weeks, but at the end, probably, Alice will be able to draw a bunch of dogs that will satisfy Bob. Now, this is exactly how GANs work, where instead of having two kids, you have two neural networks in front of each other. If you're not familiar with neural networks or machine learning in general, I suggest you to check my introduction to machine learning. The model that will draw new examples, or in our case, Alice, is called a generator, while the model that will decide whether they look real enough, which in our case was Bob, is called a discriminator. Now, what you're seeing behind me is a real set of examples. You can see a set of attempts after each iteration that a generator is drawing, trying to satisfy a discriminator. The discriminator has been given a collection of modern art painting, and it's deciding whether or not the generator's drawings are acceptable based on that. The more iteration the model does, the closer each of those drawings look like what we consider a modern piece of art. Do you think that this is what happens to our brains when we're actually creating art? I also wanted to show you this painting. This is a portrait of Edmund Bellamy. And yes, as you might have guessed, this has been drawn by a generative adversarial network. If you look closely at the bottom right corner of the picture, you'll see the signature of the artist, which is an equation. And that equation is indeed what defines the algorithm that has drawn the picture. We'll not look at the equation and the math in this video, but I thought it was an interesting concept. Edmund Bellamy is a fictional character, and his last name is the French translation of the last name of Ian Goodfellow, the creator of adversarial generative networks. Now, let's move to a different technique used by AI to create art. In this case, this AI is able to create images based on a sentence or a description. For example, you could ask this AI to draw an armature in the shape of an avocado. And this was the result. Incredible, right? So what about harder things, such as an illustration of a baby daikon radish in a tutu walking a dog? And there you go. This is what the AI drew, which is unbelievable. This AI has a name, and it's called DALL-E. It has been developed by OpenAI, and it is built on one of the most incredible languages model that exists today, which is called GPT-3. This language model is such an important technology that David Chalmers, an NYU professor of philosophy, defined it as one of the most interesting and important AI systems ever produced. If you want to check out some more artworks that have been created by DALL-E, I suggest you to check out the OpenAI website. Alright, so we've seen some powerful ways in which AI can create art, and there is a big debate around this concept. Can we actually call it art when it has been created by a machine? It's a tough question. I think about this often, and I do not have a clear opinion on this yet. But what I'm mostly excited about is when AI is used as a tool by humans to create art. One great example of this is the work made by So-Gwen Chung. In her artworks, she explores new forms of human and robotic collaborations. In her performances, she paints with the support of a robot that is learning in real time from the movements of her hands. With the help of computer vision, the drawings are analyzed gesture by gesture while she paints. In this way, the robot demonstrates a style that is inspired by her gestures. This results in a composite behavior that is made up by both the human and the artificial intelligence. The end result is brilliant. In this case, instead of artificial intelligence creating art, we can think of an AI that assumes more of a contributor's role. A similar concept is being used by one of my favorite musicians, Olafur Arnalds. Due to an injury the artist had, he was left unable to play the piano. He worked with a friend on a software that, based on his playing, generates some music along with it. This software is connected to the main piano that Olafur plays and to two other ghost pianos that will be played by the software.
Sounds super nice actually today.
This, like we've seen in the case of Soguan, creates a beautiful collaboration between humans and artificial intelligence. I hope you enjoyed this video. It's personally one of my favorite topics. So if you did enjoy it, please leave a like and a comment, and I'll make sure to make another one with some more technologists and artists. As always, if you enjoyed the video, please subscribe to the channel.